Hi, and welcome everybody. In this episode, we will travel the world in search of funky records. And we start off in the UK on the Fontana label. This is a 60s album, 1966. Beautiful cover, really. This is really, it all says 60s. The music says 60s. It are all themes from 60s spy shows like James Bond, The Adventures. They are done by a mystery group, the Red Guest Syndicate. I could not find much information about them. They do three originals on this album, the one you hear now, On the World. But they do a lot of orchestrated themes of the TV scores or the movie scores. And those are really awesome. It is 66, so it's before James Brown invented the funk. But it's very close, it really has a great groove to the music. And I guess you'll recognize this theme anywhere, everywhere. Classic stuff. For the next album, we move to Germany. And I think I showed recently also an album by this orchestra because we keep it in the same mood. This is by Peter Herbert's Heimer Orchestra from Germany, brass. So it's a lot of horns. The album itself is from 1976. It has the same vibe as the other one, although it's 10 years later. But it is really, here there's the influence a little bit more of the funk, mostly because of the brass section. But it also has this beautiful groove. And I think the orchestra with the electric bass and so on in the music really gives it a special vibe, this one. It's called Hip Walk. It looks funky. It is funky. And I must say, lately I'm really in the groove for these orchestras that do the jazz funk. It is so funky. But now we go in a completely different direction. We go to, well, I don't know, we go to a kind of mix of Sweden, UK, India. And the song that I want to sample first is Toba Toba. I think you will recognize the theme very quickly. This was also a musical, not so long ago. And this is just fun. This is the kind of albums I like. You can find them cheap. It's Salma and Sabrina, and they're doing ABBA hits from mostly the 70s albums. And it has this completely rewritten in Hindi. And this gives the music something very recognizable, but also gives it a different dimension. You don't know what they're singing about. In your mind, you're singing the English version, which shows the melodies and the music is still fun. Anything that ABBA did in the 70s is gold, but you have heard them so much. So it's fun to switch it up and go for the Hindi version. The next song I want to sample is Chiquita. And there you can feel the vibe different. That's why I selected it, because it really gives a different vibe to the song. And if you ever see this album, pick it up just to surprise people with it, because it's like the Boney M album I did previously. This one also, this has something magical. And as we are in India, it's time to move to... Oh, maybe one thing. This pressing is in the UK and you have the Indian version. As it turns out, the Indian version is the bootleg. The UK version is the original one. That's minor note. So we are in India. We have to play some Bollywood music. This one is called Disco Dancer. I don't know that much about Bollywood movies, except when you ever see the music by Bappi Lahiri or R.D. Burman, you can pick it up. Usually there are some funky, strange numbers like this one. I don't know if you can recognize where it is based on this song, but it is a Radio Killed the Video Star. The cover is really, again, beautiful. Also, the inside, it's a gatefold. I will show that during the needle drop of the next song. The one I want to sample next is Jimmy, 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 which is really beautiful. The lyrics or the vocals are not by Ashi, but by Vijay and Parva Khan, which is surprising, because Bappi used Ashi as the vocals. But as you can hear, it's crazy music. It goes in any direction. Clearly has something very catchy. The movie and the score are from 1982. You can hear that, of course, in the music. Although with Bollywood music, it can be end of the 60s, end of the halfway perhaps, or the halfway the 70s, halfway the 80s. It will all have this crazy sound to it. And I'm just in the mood sometimes to play it. Next, we move to France, a library album. It is called High Performance, of Hi-Fi Performance. It's a little bit of a strange one. I could not really place it. If it is a library album or that it is really a regular release, I think it is more in the kind of a library album. The music is from 1976. But it sounds more almost 80-like. So I think it is kind of this library album where they experimented with the instruments to create new sounds. They succeeded very well. The artists are, I think, the arrangements are done by Yvonne Uzana and Jean-Pierre Festi. Doesn't say a thing, to me anyway. The song titles are again perfect. So it's Hong Kong Connection, Dynamite Dragster, Daytona, Sweet Lovemaker. You have all these great names. These albums can really surprise you with the music on them. You could clearly hear there was still some 70s vibe, but perfect. Now we move to the US to a group that has funk in the name, so it must be funky. It's Funk Incorporated with Hanging Out. It's actually an album I always left in the bin when I saw it. That was because when I saw the cover, in my mind, this is a compilation from the 90s, or at least a weak cover from the 80s. This is completely not true. It is an album from 1973, so it is just after they did the big stretch of the famous three albums. This is number four. It's released on Prestige, and I must say it's a brilliant album. I was so wrong because of not picking it up, because it really fits with their earlier albums. So good, so funky. Now, of course, when we travel around the world, we must do a stop also in Africa. This time I chose an album which is, I think, quite easy available for a lot of people. It's not that it is released in Nigeria, although it are a Nigerian artist. It's called The Pacesetters. The name of the album, I think, is Edi Kamfo, and it is produced by Brian Eno. And it clearly shows, I think it's from 1981, so it's clearly that a lot of artists were taking interest of what was happening in Nigeria and that region of West Africa. Mostly, I think, because the influence of Fela Kuti, which was heard more around and around the world. It is not so much on this album you can hear Brian Eno or his influence. He purely did alone the production. So you have really this African band, which is really a lot of brass, more than you expect. Great sounding, and this is really one to pick out. One of the fun things, of course, is this album plays perfect. I think it is pressed in the US, or does it say? No, Do I see that right? It says made in Holland. Okay, so you have a Dutch pressing of this one. That's probably why I found it so easy and cheap. It sounds really tight. The band is really, they've been playing a lot of years together. You can hear that. With the production at a higher level, makes it very, a little bit more smooth. The rawness is a little bit gone, but it's a very enjoyable album. I also hope you enjoyed this episode. Thank you for watching. See you next time.